I'm with Emily and Jillian here from New Fork City, which is one of the most popular food Instagram accounts. Mm-hmm. They and another woman run New Fork City while they're all three are still in college mm-hmm. at three different campuses.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
None in New York. Do you believe this, how this has taken off on you?
I think we harnessed a unique opportunity when we started, and I think that's our main reason for success, but I don't think we ever pictured to have 850,000 followers at this point. When we started, food Instagrams weren't really a thing, and so we were able to get on it quickly, and we just grew organically, but we never expected down the line 4 years later for it to be this.
850,000 followers. Now, mm-hmm. straight to a business question. How do you make money from these 850,000 followers?
So typically, we have restaurants or brands that reach out to us via email, saying they want to partner or collaborate on a project that they're working with or just promote their restaurant or their business. So we have a fee that we charge and we make it happen. We go either to where they are or we have something sent to us and we take photos and then we promote on our Instagram. We use the hashtag ad or sponsored or partner so our followers know that it is a paid promotion a lot of times. And because of the FTC rules, you have to do that now because a lot of celebrities have been getting in trouble because they haven't been disclosing that they're being paid. So that's what we normally do with collaborations.
Do you two take a lot of pictures? Do you go out and take pictures?
Since the beginning, we relied heavily on our own photos, especially because when we started, we were seniors in high school. And so part of the reason we started is because our whole entire personal Instagrams were just full of food pictures. So the three of us decided to come together and create a platform where the three of us could share our photos together.
I love photography and I love food. My whole family loves food. We're very much a food family and we'll go out and try different places. And just growing up in New York City and having all these different restaurants, like endless restaurants and new places you can try, was just such an incredible opportunity that it's kind of hard not to take advantage of it. And we love the idea of just sharing where we go and the pictures that we take and the food that we enjoyed with our friends and family. And that's kind of how it started.
And then 4 years later, remarkably, you're approaching a million mm-hmm. people following your food industry information. You could not have predicted that.
Never.
Definitely not.
Never. We never started New Fork City as wanting it to become a business. I think it happened more because it was one of the first food Instagrams. We never said, let's create a food Instagram and make it as popular as we can. Mm-hmm. So it was more organic and genuine. And we posted things we thought people would want to see. And I think people are drawn to that.
Are you making a lot of money, especially, I mean, for college students still? You're making a lot of money off this, right? While you're still in college, I would assume.
For college students, definitely a lot more money than a lot of our friends. But there also were unforeseen costs that we have to do. For example, like if we have a contract, we need lawyers to look it over. We have our trademark agreements that we also need to pay for. So I think as college students, it's also been a wonderful business opportunity that was extremely rare. None of our friends have this. But it is cool to be able to be paid for a lot of these campaigns, especially as college students.
You wield a lot of power.
Yeah, definitely. It's kind of been obvious to us that people really go to our account. And well, multiple people have told us in the past, just random people we've met, that they go to before they know us, they go to our account to find restaurants to eat at. And one of the first times that we realized this was I had posted a photo of a cinnamon bun from a small bakery, and my family went the next day to go get more cinnamon buns because we love them so much. And they told us that they had like lines out the door and they'd sold out so early in the morning. And we realized that it was because we'd posted the cinnamon bun on our account and people had actually gone to the store to get them the next day.
Every time they make a post for us, and that in particular, I remember when we first opened, they posted something about our boneless wings and immediately saw a turnaround in bit. You know, the customers come in right away and they say, I saw you on Instagram, I want to try those. And it's like, wow, thank you.
General advice, using social media to become an influencer like you are. What do you tell people?
I think definitely the most important is to just be really genuine and post things you think your followers want to see. I know it's easy to, if you are offered money to post something or offered an opportunity, it's really easy to say, wow, this is amazing, let me just do it and make the whatever amount of money they're offering you, but I think it's really important to turn things down if you don't think that they fit your brand and what your followers would want to see and you wouldn't post them anyway. because it's really, people are going to you looking for advice, and they're looking for things to, restaurants to eat at and things to do, and it's very obvious if it's not very genuine, and if you're just posting things to make money, or if you're just posting things to have a lot of posts. I think quality over quantity for sure, and genuine.
Jillian, social media posting in general, Instagram or anywhere else, what advice would you give to business people?
I agree with Emily. I definitely think quality over quantity. There have been times where even photos we've taken, we didn't think would have as much success on Instagram, so we don't post them. And we've had brands reach out to us that we didn't really see fitting in with our page, so we've turned them down, even if they were offering to pay us a lot of money. So I think it's really important to stay true to who you want to be as a brand and where you want to go forward with that. And just stay true to yourself and don't really stray too far from the path, even if someone's offering you a lot of money.